The ErgingFace Dataset Library, a quick overview. The ErgingFace Dataset Library is a library that provides an API to quickly download many public datasets and preprocess them. In this video, we'll explore to do that. The downloading part is easy with the loadDataset function. You can directly download and cache the dataset from its identifier on the dataset hub. Here, we fetch the ArmorPC dataset from the Clue benchmark. It's a dataset containing pairs of sentences, where the task is to determine the paraphrasis. The object returned by the loadDataset function is a dataset dict, which is a sort of dictionary containing each split of our dataset. We can access each split by indexing with its name. The split is then an instance of the dataset class with columns. Here, sentence 1, sentence 2, label and IDX, and rows. We can access a given element by its index. The amazing thing about the ErgingFace Datasets library is that everything is saved to disk using Apache Arrow, which means that even if your dataset is huge, you won't get out of RAM. Only the elements you request are loaded in memory. Accessing a slice of your dataset is as easy as one element. The result is then a dictionary with list of values for each keys. Here, the list of labels, the list of first sentences, and the list of second sentences. The features attribute of a dataset gives us more information about its columns. In particular, we can see here it gives us the correspondence between the integers and names for the labels. 0 stands for not equivalent, and 1 for equivalent. To preprocess all the elements of our dataset, we need to tokenize them. Have a look at the video Preprocess Sentence Pairs for a refresher. But you just have to send the two sentences to the tokenizer with some additional keyword arguments. Here, we indicate a maximum length of 128 and pad inputs shorter than this length, truncate inputs that are longer. We put all of this in a tokenize function that we can directly apply to all the splits in our dataset with the map method. As long as the function returns a dictionary-like object, the map method will add new columns as needed or update existing ones. To speed up preprocessing and take advantage of the fact that our tokenizer is backed by Rust, thanks to the ErgingFace tokenizers library, we can process several elements at the same time in our tokenize function using the batch equal true argument. Since the tokenizer can handle list of first or second sentences, the tokenize function does not need to change for this. You can also use multiprocessing with the map method. Check out its documentation, linked below. Once this is done, we're almost ready for training. We just remove the columns we don't need anymore with the remove columns method, rename label to labels, since the model from the transformers library expects that, and set the output format to desired backend, Torch, TensorFlow, or NumPy. If needed, we can also generate a short sample of a dataset using the select method.